Miss Peretti, please spell syzygy.
Syzygy. S-Y-Z-Y-G-Y. Syzygy.
We have a winner!
Thank you! Thank you! Thank you!
Putnam County spelling bee. My parents keep on telling me that just being here is winning. Although I know it isn't so.
It's a very nice, very, very nice, very, very nice, very nice
beginning.
Our winner here last year, Chip Tolentino.
Stand when they announce my name.
Leave Cody Bear.
And try to keep from shaking.
Alas, his shaking will not pass.
It's a very big, very broad, simple, but it's not. It's a very big undertaking. Returning after last year's tragic setback, William Barfey.
It's pronounced Barfey. There's an accent on goo.
Thank you.
take this moment to please ask you to silence all cell phones, distracting devices, and put away all cameras. Sorry, no photos at the B. Now, if I say your name, please come down the aisle and over to our table, and we'll get you all checked in. I'm missing a Miss Naomi Herthel, Griffin Davis, Lucy Tucker, and Rebecca Trant. I also need to speak with a Miss Olive Ostrovsky.
Sorry.
Yes, dear. The school still hasn't received your $25 entrance fee.
Entrance fee?
Did the school not tell you about the entrance fee? Is your mom here, maybe? Or your dad?
My dad had to go into work. He's gonna try to come later.
Who brought you to the B, dear?
The bus.
Oh. You go take your seat. We'll talk about your fee later.
Hey, Marcy. Don't be nervous. Just watch what I do.
Don't worry.
I'm not nervous.
Have you ever been to the Virginia DeLand Cultural Arts Center before?
No, I've never even been in Virginia before.
What school do you go to?
Shut up!
Ladies and gentlemen, the children you see on stage are here for their extraordinary ability and love of language, but only one of them can go on to compete in the National B. In honor of our silver anniversary, our local sponsors, the Putnam Optometrists.
Thank you, Putnam Optometrists!
Are offering today's winner a $200 savings bond towards his or her future education. But remember, to get here, each child had to win in his or her...
Miss Peretti?
Win or place in his or her district B. So each of them is already a winner.
Already a winner.
Hi, I'm Rona Lisa Peretti, pleased to be back my ninth consecutive year as your host. Unfortunately, our usual word pronouncer, Superintendent Spriggs, has gotten the corona. So please join me in welcoming back Vice Principal Douglas Ponch. Comes to us all the way from Lake Hemingway, Dos Passos, Junior High. He's returning to us after a three-year hiatus, so thank you, Douglas, for stepping in on such short notice.
Thank you, Rona. Then as for the incident of 3 years ago, I'd like to say I'm in a much better place now. It's amazing what a changed diet can do for a man. Thank you.
Wonderful. And on top of that,
I also... And might I add, Miss Peretti is not only Putnam County's top realtor, she's also a former spelling champion herself.
Third annual.
Syzygy.
Syzygy. When the earth aligns with the moon and the sun.
That's beautiful. And now the Pledge of Allegiance, led by our comfort counselor, Miss Michelle M. Mahoney.
Michelle Mahoney is here doing her community service hours with us.
Okay, everyone, thank you. Everyone stand up. Thank you. Stand up.
Good eyes. Thank you, Michelle. Spellers, please be seated.
It is now time for the official spelling bee rules.
A speller.
Ask questions.
About the word's pronunciation and definition.
Definition.
In a sentence. And language of origin. Start to spell a word, you may start over.
But the sequences of letters already spoken may not be changed.
If you misspell a word,
we will ring
the bell. And the comfort counselor,
Mish Mahoney.
Proceedings turn snide, and contestants turn nasty. I soberly
without further ado, let the spelling begin with Miss Schwartz and Rubenier.
Miss Schwartz and Rubenier is head of the Gay Straight Alliance at her elementary school.
Ally.
Strabismus.
Strabismus. May I have a definition of that word?
The inability of one eye to obtain binocular vision with the other because of an imbalance of the muscle in the eyeball.
And in a sentence, please.
Sure. In the schoolyard, Billy protested that he wasn't cockeyed. I suffer from strabismus, he said, whereupon the bullies beat him harder.
Notice how she writes on her forearm. It's so she can see the word before she speaks it out loud.
Strabismus. S-T-R-A-B-I-S-M-U-S. Strabismus.
That is correct. Mr. Coney Bear.
Mr. Leaf Coney Bear came as second runner-up in his school's District B.
Rogue, will you tell Leaf he has a phone call, please?
Leaf, phone!
Oh, thanks, I got it. Hello, Leaf speaking. Oh, you're kidding. I'm going to represent the Bacon in the Bee? Oh, I can't believe it. Hey, Mom, Dad, Marigold, Pinecone, Landscape, Raisin, Paul. You're not going to believe this.
What's up, Leaf?
I made the finals in the county spelling bee.
No, sweetheart. You came in third, honey.
Yeah, well, I know that, but they just called and they said the person who came in first has to go to their bat mitzvah, and the person who came in second has to attend that bat mitzvah, and so they want me to do it.
You do realize that all the other kids will have one in their district B's.
Capybara.
What?
Your word is capybara.
Is that a word?
Yup, it's a word.
Oh, what does it mean?
It's a tailless, largely aquatic South American rodent, often exceeding 4 feet in length.
What else can I ask?
You're allowed to ask language of origin or to be used in a sentence.
Could you use it in a sentence?
Sure. Don't look now, Pedro, but I think that tailless, largely aquatic, 4.5-foot rodent swimming next to you may be a capybara.
Oh, wow, that didn't help at all.
Are you going to spell the word, Mr. Coney Bear?
No. But it was fun to come here. Hi, guys. My whole family's here, which is really C-A-P-Y-B-A-R-A. Capybara?
That is correct.
Yes.
Ms. Ostrovsky.
Miss Ostrovsky came in second in her school's Halloween costume contest.
I was roadkill.
Philanthropy.
Philanthropy. May I have a definition?
The delusion that one has become an ox.
Oh, excuse me, ma'am, can you not sit in that seat? I saved a chair for my dad in the fourth row on the aisle, and it may take him. Washes herself in the Ganges, and I live.
correct.
My friend, a dictionary is a very reliable friend. Trip to Sing Sing, Billy learned that bending over to receive your Zuzu is a no-no.
Z-U-Z-U.
Impressive and correct. Told you vigintillion times. Those magazines are for daddy.
V-I-G-I-N-T-I-L-A-N.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is V-I-G-I-N-T-I-L-L-I-O-N. That is incorrect.
Goodbye. You were goodbye, not good enough. So we know that's why can't we say goodbye?
Mr. Barfy.
It's pronounced Barfay!
Mr. Barfy has a rare mucous membrane disorder.
Lugubrious.
Yes, of course, lugubrious! Meaning extremely sad and droopy.
More or less, yes.
A topic I am all too familiar with. One moment, please.
Watch this technique. He calls it the magic foot. He writes the word out on the floor. It's so he can visualize it before speaking it out loud. Incredible.
Lugubrious. L-U-G-U. Lugub. B-R-I-O-U-S. Lugubrious.
That is correct.
I know.
Griffin. Mexican.
Mexican.
Only the spell on the microphone is allowed to speak. Sorry.
Can I have a definition?
Sure. A resident of Mexico, or an American slang term for anybody from Puerto Rico, the Dominican Republic, South America, or Spain.
Can you use this sentence?
Oh, tortilla no. Chips, the Mexican lettuce.
Mexican. M. E. X. I. C. A-N.
Job, Minister. Yes.
Thank you. May I have the definition, please?
Either of two small square leather boxes containing religious texts traditionally worn on the left arm and head by Jewish men during morning weekday prayers.
Thank you. May I have a sentence, please?
Billy put down that phylactery. We're Episcopalian.
Thank you. Phylactery. P-H-Y-L-A-C-T-E-R-Y. Phylactery.
That is correct.
Slam dunk from Park.
Mr. Colantino.
Hey, Marcy. Don't be... you went to Nationals, right? Do you remember me?
I only remember the top 10.
Charlito Chip Colantino is a little league pitcher with a wicked 22-mile-an-hour screwball.
Omphaloskepsis.
Wait, but didn't Mr. Foot Fetish just get Mexican?
Yep, and you got omphaloskepsis.
What are those two words rated at the same level of difficulty?
They're both level 1 words, yes.
Omphaloskepsis. Could it also be pronounced omphaloskepsis?
It would, and you'd be wrong.
Omphaloskepsis. O-M-P-H-A-L-O-S-K-E-P-S-I-S. Omphaloskepsis.
That is correct.
He rallies and nails it. That lady's the champion.
Home run, baby.
Naomi.
Naomi Herzl Googles how to cry.
Cow.
Cow!
Only to spell her at the microphone. He's allowed to speak.
Define that.
It means cow.
Sentence, please.
Please spell cow.
Cow. C-O-W.
That is correct.
My oh my.
That was so ironic.
Super short
spell, gerbil.
That
Cystitis.
Cystitis? May I have a definition of that word?
Inflammation of the urinary bladder.
And in a sentence, please?
Sally's mother told her it was her cystitis that made her special.
Cystitis? I think I studied this one with my dad.
Segway.
S-E-G-U-E.
Good. Siphon.
S-I-P-H-O-N.
Good. Cystitis.
F-I...
No.
C.
Good.
I...
Are you concentrating?
Yes.
Hey, okay, maybe it's time for a break.
We're in the middle of the war, Dan.
You know she doesn't spell good when her blood sugar is low, Carl.
The bee can last up to 3 hours. We need to build up her stamina.
Wow. Don't you talk to me about stamina.
Daddy conference now.
Wait, Dad, let me get this word first, please.
Cystitis.
Cystitis. C-Y-S-T-I-T-I-S, cystitis.
That is correct, Mr. Coney Bear.
Mr. Coney Bear makes his own clothes.
A coochie. Listen to the whole word, please. A coochie.
Out of spelling bee? What does it mean?
It's a South American rodent of the genus Myoprocopta, resembling an agouti.
It's funny how I keep getting all the South American rodents.
It's hilarious.
Look, honestly, I've never heard this word before, and I have no idea how to spell it.
You can either spell the word or forfeit your turn.
Why don't you just give it your best shot, Mr. Coney Bear?
I'm not that smart. My siblings have been telling me that for years, that I'm not smart. What's good at home, they see who's right, it breaks my heart. I'm not that smart. Hey.
One of my more aggressive family. Everyone keeps wanting.
Dumb kid.
Everyone keeps yelling.
Dumb kid.
How beautifully such as me think he'd be good at spelling. How. I like my hair. Really, it is pleasant to the touch. I toss my hair a bit too much. It doesn't move, it simply sits. I make a part. I'm not that smart. Da da. I've forgotten the word.
Oh my god. A coochie!
Oh yeah. The rodent resembling the other. What was.
A C O U C H I!
A coochie.
That is correct.
I might be smart. My siblings can't believe that I got it right. I got it right. I saw this life, the view was neat. I like to laugh, I like to smell, I like to. And if this competition's hell, at least I'm finally apart. I feel my heart begin to swell. I like. I love.
Flagellate.
Flagellate. That's a verb, right?
Can I ask you to speak clearly into the microphone, please?
Sorry!
Dear, there's no need to be sorry. Just turn, no, but stay at the mic.
Stay at the mic, please.
At the mic, at. Someone needs to teach this girl to stand like a champion. Right over to the mic, dear. Hair out of your face, chin up, shoulders back. Beautiful. Oh, it's a tough age for girls.
I fell.
And boys. You see, with this difference, if you ask a child if they expect to win the spelling bee, they're trained to respond differently. Most boys will say,
I'm taking it all! You're all going down!
Most girls will say,
honestly, I think there's a good chance I would do okay, but it's unlikely I'd win the whole thing. You see, I'm a good speller, but I'm not truly a great speller, and although I have trained so hard, there's so much luck involved.
But I find the girls are usually thinking,
I'm taking it all! You're going down! Sucker!
Well, the guys are usually thinking,
I don't really know. Am I good enough or not?
I'm thinking about, does flagellate have one L or two? And also about how if we take the W of answer and the H in ghost and the extra A in aardvark and the T in listen, you could keep saying what, but nobody would hear because the whole word would be silent.
You still need to speak up, Miss Clistrons.
Flagellate! F-L-A-G-E-L-L-A-T-E! Flagellate!
That is correct, and good on the volume. Julie, is that girl in, like, the very back row with the fuzzy sweater, like, right there? Like, is that your sister?
Oh, yeah, that's Mary Gold.
Oh, she's really pretty. Griffin!
Griffin Davis is the sixth member of Maroon 5.
Griffin, your word today is exdesius. A definition. A striptease artist.
Can I use it in a sentence?
Politically correct Tom told his son, use exdesius. The word stripper is insulting.
exdesius. X. D.
Oh.
E. E. Z. S. U. S.
I'm sorry, the correct spelling is E. C. D. Y. S. I. A. S. T. That is incorrect.
Let's see what we got here. H-A-S-E-N.
Tucker.
Lucy Tucker is on the no-fly list.
Your word today is Jafail.
Definition, please.
A costly mistake made by a lawyer in court.
Use it in a sentence.
Please try on this glove. Jafail.
J-A-F-A-I-L. Jafail.
Very close. The correct spelling is J-E-O-F-A-I-L. That is incorrect.
Goodbye.
I'll go now.
Another excellent decision from the incumbent.
Give me a minute, please.
Tit up.
What?
Your word is tit up.
May I have a definition, please?
Lively movement or behavior. It refers to the sound of a horse's hooves. Tit up, tit up, tit up.
Okay. T-I-T-U. Oh, wait, sorry. Two T's. T-I-T-T-U-P, tit up.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is T-I-T-T-U-P.
That's exactly what I said, sorry.
Nope, you said T-I-T-U, oh wait, two T's.
But I spelled it right. I can't get out on a word that I spelled right, guys. I won last year.
The word you may start over, but
the secret to the land of daddy, so the man, I'll be back.
There's nothing you can say to them to cheer them up when they lose. I want to tell them disappointment doesn't last, but from what I've seen, disappointment lasts like hell. I want to tell them words don't matter, but from what I've seen, words can get you killed. I just want to beat the shit out of them, you know, a little bit, so they understand that pain has degrees and this is nothing. It's nothing! Fucking freaks. But that would violate my parole, so I do what I can. I give him a hug and a juice box. I'm here to give comfort. Let's go.
Can I please have another chance?
Let's go, kid.
Please.
This
Naomi, please spell chair.
Definition.
An object to sit on.
Can I have a sentence?
I am sitting in a chair.
Chair. C-H-A-I-R.
That is correct. Naomi!
Naomi is against hunting and chooses to fist fight the animals instead.
Please spell sleep.
Definition, please.
To sleep.
Sleep. S-L-E-E-P.
That is correct. Naomi!
Naomi has a shrine dedicated to Kermit the Frog.
We spell green.
Green. Wait, can I have a definition, please?
The color.
Green. G-R-E-E-N.
Impressive and correct. Naomi!
Naomi has an abundant addiction.
Please spell pneumono ultra microscopic silico volcano coniosis.
Can I have the definition, please?
Lung disease caused by silica dust in the air.
Can you say that like three times?
I'll say it once for you.
Okay.
Pneumono ultra microscopic silico volcano coniosis. Try spelling it this time.
Okay. P N E U M O N I. That's all I remember.
You were pretty close. The correct spelling is P N E U M O N O U L T R A M I C R O S C O P I C S I L I C O V O L C A N O C O N Y O S I S. Pretty close, but incorrect.
Yeah. Oh, all right.
My friend, you will be missed. But now go with dignity. This ends the first on our list. Oh, you can go with pride. You're a smart chick as well. Now go with yourself. Give a squeeze my face. Thank you.
lobby at this moment. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. Snack break. Who wants candy? It's only a dollar.
I have a better dollar.
Okay. Wait.
Actually, I have a $5.
Oh, I think that's worth more than this. I don't know. Oh, a lot of people want candy. You know what? Screw it. Who wants free candy?
Please.
Olive, I love.
it.
Ladies and gentlemen, our final spellers, let's give them a hand.
Hey, look, Mom, I'm in the finals.
From Our Lady of Intermittent Sorrows, Miss Marcy Park.
I'm not all business.
From Cold Spring Country Day, Mr. William Barfy.
Barfay!
From Garrison Elementary, Miss Olive Ostrovsky.
Miss Pretty, my dad.
It's okay. And from the Magna Magna Grammar School, Miss Logan Schwartz and Grubinier.
I would just like to take this one moment to thank my two fathers, Daniel Schwartz and Carl Grubinier, who have been so supportive of me and all of my endeavors. Thanks, Dad.
Barfy! It's Barfy!
that is incorrect. The correct spelling is L-I-L-L-I-A, chinchilla.
To be incredibly handsome.
Antihistamine.
Welcome to draw. One moment, please. A-N-T-I-H-I-S-T-A-M-I-N-E. Antihistamine, Mr. Panchi.
Doug Ponch.
Will Barfay.
Miss Park.
Miss Park speaks 5 languages.
No, I don't.
Don't you?
No.
Well, it says you won your school's handwriting competition.
And does it also say that I only sleep 3 hours a night, I hide in my bathroom cabinet, and I'm not allowed to cry?
No, it doesn't.
Well, it should. And it should say, I speak 6 languages.
Six.
Every language easy. Easy as the recipe for making jello. I speak 6 languages. And I can say hello. In at least 7 more, I can say you're an athlete. To excel in athletics is not difficult. The ball has to temperament. Apparently, I have the temperament.
Always speak.
six lousy languages. And for my height, I'm the lightest of the girls in my class.
We know six languages.
That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We know six.
Miss Park, please spell camouflage.
Camouflage? Dear Jesus, you can't come up with a harder word than that.
Of course I can, my child.
Jesus!
Marcy.
Hi, I was hoping you'd be Asian, but it's okay.
I know you. Well, you just get a half Jew. I'm doing good. Now, Marcy, is that your prayer for a more difficult word?
Well, it was, but now that you're here, can I ask for something better?
I'm here for you, my child.
Jesus, I was just wondering, what would happen if I didn't win today?
What do you think would happen, Marcy?
Well, I don't know. I guess what I'm asking is, would you be disappointed in me if I lost?
Of course not. But Marcy, I also wouldn't be disappointed if you win.
So you're saying it's up to me, then?
Yes, and also, this isn't the kind of thing I care about. Sing, children!
Camouflage. C-A-M-O-U-F-L-A-Z-J-H. Camouflage! I do that word.
Mind if we get back to the spelling.
You didn't give me my word.
I gave you a word.
No, you didn't.
I didn't give her a word.
No.
Sluice.
Sluice. May I have a definition of that word?
An artificial passage of water with a valve or gate for stopping and regulating flow.
Any alternate definition?
Sure. A channel to drain or carry surplus water.
Any alternate definition?
Sure. It's a body of water pent up behind a floodgate.
Any alternate definition?
Why don't you quit stalling and spell the damn word?
Principal Punch.
It's Vice Principal Punch. It's Vice Principal! Because God knows they would have made me a principal!
Gee, I wonder why.
Flute. F-L-U-I-C-E, flute.
That is correct. How dare you!
But wouldn't that be wrong?
Isn't having a magic foot an unfair advantage?
I don't have a magical foot.
Or a mother.
Oh. Have all parents please return to your seats? This is not a soccer game.
You're lucky your parents are in India.
No, only my mom is. My dad's coming from work.
I'd like to apologize for that incident. I'd like to say I'm lactose intolerant. Let's continue with Ms. Ostrovsky.
Miss Pretty, what did my dad say?
He's running a few minutes late, but he'll discuss the entrance fee with you when he picks you up.
Chimerical.
What was the word?
Chimerical.
Can I have a definition?
It means unreal. Imaginary, visionary, wildly fanciful, highly unrealistic.
Will I be on my own?
Y-C-A-L. Highly unrealistic, wildly fanciful.
That is correct.
Dialects, a Latin derivative.
Fuck. That's like English, Dutch influence. Fuck. V-U-G-G-H-E. Fuck.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is V-U-G. Fuck.
Thank you.
It does not happen to be the longest word. You can turn upside down and it still be the same word.
Fabacy.
Fabacy. It does not happen to be the longest word that can be played on a musical instrument.
Chromatophore.
Chromatophore. And if you were to rearrange the letters of that word, could you form the phrase, Mr. Poo in a Rock?
Or Chee Poo, Mr.
Pop Home Carrots.
Pop Home Cohort.
Mr. Barfy, please spell Astro League.
I'm in Santa.
I'll lose, and that's the story.
all right, Barf.
UNG Feltenschung.
We have a winner! $200 scholarship towards his future education to William Barfee.
I worked so hard for this moment. All my life, I've only been able to breathe through one nostril. And today is no exception!
And this year there's a runner-up prize.
There is?
Yes. If the Putnam County champ cannot assume his duties as Putnam County champ, our sponsors have offered a $25 cash prize to our second place runner-up.
Thank you. Thank you. I can't believe it. Miss Freddy, I can pay the fee now.
Very good. Very good.
Very good.
Good bee.
You too, Frosty.
Well, I made a dumb mistake on Eli Wesson's.
No, I didn't know how to spell it either.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I totally knew how to spell it.
Hey, Barb.
Yeah?
Congratulations.
Of course.
Vice Principal Ponch found a new passion in his life, and her name was Rona Lisa Peretti. After courting her tirelessly for 2 years, she took out a restraining order on him, but he was still finally grateful to finally experience love.
Rona Lisa Peretti left Putnam County for a stretch and to travel the world. She implemented national spelling bees in countries such as Sweden, Latvia, and the Republic of New Guinea-Bissau, where she met an indigenous cashew farmer and fell in love. She also happens to be one of the top realtors in that country.
Mish Mahoney discovered a new talent at the Putnam Bee, so she decided to make her community service lifelong, comforting eliminated spellers and frustrated educators all across the nation. And over the years, she kept in touch with the scores of people that she had comforted.
Dear Mish!
Chip Tomatino made it through his adolescence and came to appreciate his erection, as did many others.
Marcy Clark continued to explore the freedoms of not living up to expectations. She later wrote a book called Not Living Up to Expectations. It did not live up to expectations. She's very happy.
Leaf Coney Bear has cats.
Looking towards a year winner when the 31st annual Putnam County Spelling Bee on her 7th year and final year of eligibility. She then became Secretary of President under Jane Lynch.
Her speech therapy was completely successful.
William Morris Barfay studied for nationals with his new friend, Oliver Strofsky. He came in 42nd, top 50. In later years, he grew to become incredibly handsome and to gain fame and notoriety for his pioneering efforts in the scientific fields of psychiatry and podiatry, also known as psychiatry.
Olga Strofsky reenacted the entire bee for her father on the car ride home. She grew up to be a loving and attentive parent and the host of her own radio talk show, where every year she interviews the runner-up of the Putnam County.